I'm glad to welcome here Josep Borrell, High Representative of the European Union for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy and the Vice President of the European Commission. Mr. Borrell is in charge of coordinating the external action of the European Union. Before his current position, he served as the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Spain. Please, Mr. Borrell, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Thank you for this invitation. Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, this debate comes not only on the 75th anniversary of the end of the Second World War in Europe, but also during the 75th anniversary of the United Nations. And tomorrow, in May, the European Union will celebrate the 17th anniversary of the Schuman Declaration. We are making these occasions, but not only Europe, but the world at large is facing its biggest crisis since the end of the World War. A health, economic, and social crisis triggered by the outbreak of COVID-19. Our task is to use the commemorations to draw the right lessons to prevent future atrocities and protect human life and dignity. The two wars left Europe devastated and hungry. But out of the rubbles, the European Union was born. The European Union's founders imagined a continent that instead of exporting war, would promote peace, democracy, and human development within its borders and around the world. And from the beginning, the European project has been based on the values of solidarity, openness, freedom, and respect for the rule of law. We, of course, share these values with the United Nations. So, the European Union and the United Nations are sisters and brothers in our DNA. We share historical circumstances from which we stem and principles and values upon which are we based. And these are needed today more than ever. The outbreak of COVID-19 clearly demonstrates that global challenges require collective action. It's a test for humanity, but also to the multilateral system itself. The current crisis is shaking the foundation of our societies and exposing the vulnerabilities of the most fragile countries. It has the potential to deepen existing conflicts and generate new geopolitical tensions. It's a reminder that peace, democracy, and prosperity must constantly be nurtured, expanded, and made more inclusive. The rules-based international order, with the United Nations at its core, must be upheld and strengthened. The EU is doing its part for international peace and security in many theaters and crises on the agenda of the Security Council in close partnership with the United Nations itself, but also with the African Union, the OCE, and others. The European Union and its member states also provide almost one third of the contributions to the United Nations budget, to its funds and agencies. We invest in them because we believe it is in our own interest and that of the world to do so. Our contributions to the humanitarian and development activities of the United Nations are an investment in the security of all. But today we are now at a turning point. We need to strengthen solidarity and global cooperation to win the battle against a virus that knows no borders. This is why the European Union has put its full weight behind Secretary General Guterres to push to coordinate a United Nations-wide response. And we were one of the earliest and loudest backers of his call for a global ceasefire. Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, this is an opportunity to revitalize the peace and security agenda in terms of conflict prevention, peace building, and strengthening of peacekeeping. We must guarantee humanitarian access to vulnerable populations, and we must ensure effective global action on new security threats, including those that abuse cyber technologies. In all this, we must safeguard the fundamental freedoms and rights of our citizens. Today, we need a United Nations that delivers for all and that fits for purpose. At a time of growing skepticism, we need to demonstrate its added value and relevance and to restore trust in multilateral cooperation for the common good. That's why the European Union will be always at the forefront of those advocating a more effective, efficient, and sustainable finance United Nations, in full support of the United Nations Secretary General Reforms Agenda. Beyond the immediate public health challenges of today, the international response must put people at the center, tackle inequalities, and uphold human rights for all. Millions of people around the world are still displaced by persecution, conflict, and atrocities, and we must not be afraid to insist that human rights are universal and must be upheld equally everywhere. That means also for Syrians, for Yemenis and Rohingya, for Venezuelans, and for Palestinians. Also, we commemorate the 75th anniversary of the liberation of Auschwitz. We must act against the reemergence of anti-Semitism, racism, xenophobia, and authoritarian politics. No one should be discriminated for their origins or their religious or political beliefs. As the Secretary General Antonio Guterres has warned, the pandemic risks inciting waves of hate and xenophobia, scapegoating, and scaremongering. The Security Council must provide the political will to act, and we must ensure early prevention action and assist the states in fulfilling their responsibility to protect. We are beginning to understand how human health and planetary health are linked and how existing inequalities are making us more vulnerable than we believe. This crisis is also an opportunity to build back better, just as our predecessors rebuilt a better world from the ashes of war. A key way we can do so is by fully implementing Agenda 2030 for sustainable development and the Paris Agreement on climate change. On this, the European Union's commitment and record is strong, and we count on others to meet their obligations too. At its best, the European Union is a symbol of the progress made since the end of the Second World War to advance human rights, democracy, and the rule of law, and to set aside all tribal animosities. At a time when humanity is under threat, we need states, above all those who carry the heavy responsibility of Security Council membership, to lift their horizons, to reaffirm the founding values of the United Nations, and to promote those values at home and abroad. As Robert Schuman, one of the founding fathers of the European Union, said 70 years ago, world peace cannot be safeguarded without undertaking creative efforts proportionate to the dangers that threaten it. And today, the threats are bigger than ever, and so it has to be our efforts. Each of us bear a special responsibility. The mural that decorates the room where this meeting normally takes place tells us a story we should not forget. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to contribute alive this memory.
Thank you, Mr. Borrell, for your statement and for bringing the voice of Europe to our debate.